Welcome to my YouTube video. Today we are going to be unboxing the Owlcrate box. Oh my gosh, I'm excited. Everyone was talking about the color of the box, and I have it right here, you guys. Now, I know Owlcrate did ask their viewers, I think on Instagram, I'm not sure if it was on any other platform, but I do want to say that on Instagram, they were asking if people wouldn't mind if maybe they shared the actual box color for this month. I really don't care. Like, I am not one of those people that I'm like, oh my God, spoiler alert. I am totally fine with it. But I understand the whole situation with the content in it. But you guys, this is really cool. Like, I really love it. Now, I know in their Owlcrate Junior boxes, this color is kind of, I think it's a little bit lighter, but it's in the inside of the box in the Owlcrate Junior boxes. But yeah, I thought this was really cool though. It's very different from their usual traditional, just like tan kind of color box. I do have my trusty scissors here, and let's get opening this up because I don't want to distract you guys from me constantly talking as I usually do. And ooh, even the tape is like, the bluish color. Love the details, Owlcrate. So let's start to open this up. Let me get my nails in there and make sure that I'm holding on to anything that could possibly come out. So this is how it looks right here when you first get it, which I know right now from the looks of it, it does look like most of it was covered for you guys. But I'm gonna move these squigglies right here. I do save these, by the way. I had reused them for some Easter bags actually. And I was like really, really happy because instead of me buying the packets, you know, from the store, I was able to reuse these. So just in case you guys have another idea, I know sometimes I tend to save them also during Christmas time to use it as stuffing as well. So that is another idea. All right, so this actually flew right out, but it says an Owlcrate production. Music of the night. That is the theme for the month of March. And this is a beautiful little print, which actually matches the box. I wonder if that was actually intentional or not. But yeah, so it says Owlcrate's 5-year anniversary. Oh yeah, that's true. It's Owlcrate's 5-year anniversary, you guys. That is very true. I wonder if that's the reason why the box is the color that it is. Oh, where to start? Because I already see some good stuff. Let me pull out something that I'm already seeing, which is this right here. I know they tend to give us a variety of socks inspired by different types of books, but this one in particular is for Owlcrate. Look at the little owls. Oh, so this is some Owlcrate merch right here. It says Owlcrate loves you. Okay, so these are so cool. Oh my gosh, I love it. Love, love, love the neutral colors. And then we also have this one called the Goblin Grove Winterberry Peach. This is from Flick the Wick. I love their candles. Oh, so good. It smells really, really good. It has that nice little blue tone on there as well. Like I said, I think all of this is like a theme, to be honest with you guys. Yeah, I just wanted to make sure that the lid was on there as well. I can smell the little peach. Oh, it just smells so like a fresh fruit scent that you would get in the summer. It smells good. Okay. And then we also have this little thing. It's so cute. What is this? Bella's Lullaby Mint Chocolate Chip Lip Scrub. That's really cool because I haven't seen like a lip scrub at all. I gotta get some scissors here. I don't think we've ever received any kind of lip scrub, so that's really cool. And my lips get so chapped, so dry and flaky sometimes. And yeah, so I always have to hydrate, but sometimes, you know, it's good to exfoliate your lips. And now we have this, but I'm assuming the Bella is from Twilight, I want to say. But this is so cool. Look at it. Oh my gosh. Let's see. Ooh, let's see if it smells. Oh yeah, look at that. A nice look. It looks like a sugar scrub. Oh my gosh, it does smell like chocolate. It's supposed to be mint chocolate chip, so it does smell like chocolate. All right, now another thing we have is this print right in here. Okay, you guys see that? Let me pull it out really quickly. Let's see how it looks. The Phantom of the Opera, you guys. This is really neat. And I want to say I have a picture frame that I can actually put this in and put it in my library. This is a beautiful print, you guys. Let me get a little bit closer so you guys can see the details on it. I hope you guys can see all of that. Look at all that. Oh, all the masks and everything. Oh my gosh. Nice print. I love that. Okay, another thing I see here is Ex Libris. Oh, this is like Hedwig right here. Let me pull it out and see what this is. Hold on, let me get this because I have tape right here. Okay, let me pull it out. Oh, it's so cute. What is it? note cards. Oh, okay, I see what these are. Okay, these are like book plates right here. So you can put right here your name that it belongs to you. And then in the back, it's kind of like a sticker. So you'll be able to bend it right here and peel it off and put it in your book if you want to say like, oh, it belongs to me. This is really cool. I want to say in the one of the other months for the Owlcrate Junior, they offered some book plates for the kiddos. But this one is so cool. It's really, really nice, you guys. So this is inspired by Harry Potter right here, little book plates. And then there is this. What is it? It's not a mug. Usually it comes in like a box, but it's a little taller. Speaker? Owlcrate wireless speaker? What? A mini wireless speaker, you guys. Oh, Owlcrate, you are outdoing yourself. What? Oh my gosh, that is so cool. And then you have this, which I'm assuming, so you can hang it and put it anywhere you want, or you can carry it with you. Oh, we got this little USB cord as well. Oh my gosh, I wonder how it looks. Oh my gosh, it is so nice. Ah, this is so cute, you guys. Look at the speaker. Oh, and it looks like it has headphones right here. Oh my goodness, you guys. I am blown away. What? Owlcrate, how? This is awesome. This is really, really cool. I am for sure going to be putting this in my little library. This is so, so cool. Let me see what it probably says more about it. Let me see. We included an Owlcrate wireless speaker for all of your listening needs, for audiobooks to podcasts and music. Yay! All right, let's continue, you guys. So I do have this in this container right here. I'm going to pull it out. What is, oh my goodness, this is cool. Sing You a Song and Steal Your Soul by Victoria Schwab. Oh my goodness, you guys, this is a plate right here, you guys, if you guys can see. Oh my gosh, it's like etched too. Like I said, it's kind of, it feels beveled right there. I just don't know if you guys would be able to see it. This is a very, very well done print. It does seem like it's on some kind of like bamboo kind of wooden style backing. I don't know. It's hard to tell, you guys. I don't know if it's wood or bamboo, but it looks kind of bamboo-ish. This is really cool. This would be like a nice print to probably like lean somewhere. Super adorable. Okay, and then we also have this, which is the pin. Usually it is inspired by the actual book that we have in here, so I don't want to spoil it, but I do want to show you guys this. So let me pull it out right here. Looks so nice. Look at that, the blue colors again going with the theme. Love it, love it. But it looks so cool. It's like two trees, you know, or like a reflection of the tree. And then also back here, you do see two clasps right here, you guys. So I'm going to be adding those to my pin board. And then finally for the book, I believe, because that is it, right? Yes, yes, it is. Is this one. Oh my gosh, it does look like the book. Okay, let me peel this off. You guys, I just noticed something. So of course we get exclusive covers. I don't know what the original looks like, but I will show you guys after this. But this is so beautiful. We do got the note from the actual author herself. So it's Marie Lu. And oh my gosh, this is beautiful. Okay, this is how it looks, but check this out, you guys. Okay, I'm gonna come to it. This is the back, but then look at the sprayed edges. Silver. Oh my goodness, look at that. Oh, this is amazing. This is really good. This is a very nice exclusive kind of book to have, for real. Oh, let's see. Okay, without the dust jacket, how the actual cover of the book looks like. Look at that, beautiful. It's kind of engraved and it has that silver right there. And then, oh, this is so beautiful that if you were to lose the dust jacket or just not want it, this would display beautifully on your bookshelf. Oh, so nice, you guys. Okay, I am gonna come back here. Oh, and then there's also a map right here, you guys. That is really cool. I love to get maps. It kind of helps me like figure and imagine things a little bit better for me. But this is so cool. It says here in the back, I am the sister of the other Mozart and her story is mine. Interesting. So I'm going to read a little bit here and I'm going to come back and see what it's about. And then we're going to get to what the theme of the April box is. And we will also see what the original cover is going to be. So I'm going to be right back. All right, you guys, well, this is definitely a whole other take. This is going to be a little bit of somewhat, I think, fantasy at the same time, but it is historical fiction, you guys. And from what I'm reading here, according to this Nannerl Mozart, I believe that's her name, she is really great at composing and making music, and she just constantly wants to be like a well-known composer. But her dad said no. It's actually forbidden for her to be a composer, and her dad had told her that it is until she is of age of marriage that she will be able to perform anything. And she does have a younger brother who is really great at composing as well, and she's kind of getting tired of waiting. It seems like every year that she waits for her opportunity to shine, it just, like, she feels like it's further and further away from the reality of her actually becoming a composer that she's always dreamed of. Now, there is a stranger that comes into play and promises to help her become this great, well-known composer, but I think there's going to be a catch there. And of course, this talks about her and her unbreakable bond with her brother. So I'm assuming there's going to be some kind of situation that arises during this story. Probably has something to do with the brother, but I'm not too sure, or maybe the father. I'm not quite sure. This is basically a choice that she's gonna have to make, whether she goes with a stranger, which I'm pretty sure she probably is. And there's going to be some things that are going to arise from that. So this is a really interesting story. Now, I do want to show you guys really quickly what the actual original one is, which is actually not too far off, you guys. As you guys can tell right here, you have the Owlcrate one, and then this one is the original one. This is just like more of a darker blue, or is it black? I'm not too sure. But yeah, so this is what the exclusive cover is, and this is the regular book. Now, I'm pretty sure that the original one doesn't actually come with sprayed edges. I'm thinking that's just exclusive to the Owlcrate one, and it is awesome. Like, I think that is so cool. All right, so the theme for the month of April, we got here, full moon magic. Ooh, I wonder if there's going to be some kind of wolf inspired things in here. Like, I don't know, maybe they might have a Twilight stuff in here. But either way, you guys, this is what the theme is. I love these cards. They're so beautiful, to be honest with you guys. Ugh. Now it says every April box will include an exclusive jigsaw puzzle illustrated by Alien Art. So this is really cool. Already, I love the picture they do have right here. So that is really nice. All right, you guys. Well, I'm going to conclude this video. I'm going to try to enjoy all this stuff while we're hunkering down here in our homes. I hope you guys are safe. Also, you guys, if you guys receive Owlcrate unboxings, what's an item that really stood out to you? To me, it was that speaker. I was not expecting that. But I love everything that I did receive here in this box. Also, if you are someone who probably doesn't get Owlcrate, but you guys are watching this video right now, what is something that really intrigued you as well? So comment down below. I love to hear your guys' feedback. I also hope that all you guys are doing well right now. Stay safe. And until next time, you guys. And remember, you guys, don't forget to like this video. That would really help me out here on YouTube. And also subscribe if you want to see more content from me. And click the notification button down below in case you want to get notified every time I upload. So until next time, you guys, toodles!